do avalanches occur?
Snow avalanches happen when a heavier weight of snow is above a weak layer of snow. This can happen during a storm called sloughing or weeks later as the snow changes. In nature, nothing remains the same. Snow morphs and changes as it tries to reach equilibrium. What is needed is a trigger, a skier, a cornice drop, or even a snowball that melts, rolls down a slope. A bomb is a huge trigger. In short, energy is in the snowpack. Where does this energy go and how it's released is the problem.
At what degree slopes do avalanches occur?
Avalanches are more likely on slopes between 25 to 50%. They are more destructive on these slopes. On steeper slopes, the snow is released naturally more often during a storm, not building up to the point that the entire weight causes the snow to slide to the ground. Avalanches occur on less steep slopes too, just less often because gravity is less of a factor.
How does it affect the landscape?
Do you remember walking to Williams Lake and seeing open areas missing any trees? This is due to large slides taking out all the trees. I remember seeing these areas as a small boy myself. It amazed me, but I had no idea what caused this path straight down the hill. Now I know, avalanches.
What can ski patrols do to eliminate an avalanche?
On a Class A mountain that has a lot of avalanches, the ski patrol has to control the snow and avalanches before we allow skiers up the hill. If we bury someone, they may die of suffocation. So we go hunting for trouble, knowing our backyard. We know how much snow fell. We know how much wind loaded critical locations, what direction the wind blew, what the temperature was during the whole storm. Most important, what type of snow is under the new snow. We then load up the bombs, mostly 2-pounders, to throw into the starting zone of an avalanche path to pull the trigger and make them slide before anyone below is hurt. We also ski across the starting zone from a safe spot to another safe spot, pushing with our skis on the snow to try to get the snow slab to break loose. I have done this lots of times and got caught a few times. I have places named for me on places I've been caught. What happens when you get caught? You fight to stay as high on the slope as you can and let most of the snow flush to the bottom. You dig in with your poles to hold on, kind of like an ice axe to stay near the top.
Have you ever seen or been in an avalanche?
Yes, this is one of the major benefits of working as a ski patroller, to see nature doing its magic. Avalanches come in all sizes, small to huge. It can be an emotion of excitement when you release a big slide, yelling in delight. It can also be a time when a patroller realizes that he could be hurt or worse, scared, because he was closer to being caught in a big slide. In closing, being up on top of the mountains watching the sunrise can make one cry in amazement of life. Trusting your partners and yourself when your life is on the line, this shared experience is one of the gifts of being a mountain person, the sharing.